What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel, and welcome to another Pokemon Sword and Shield VGC 2021 video. Now, I have been having just the worst experience in Great Ball this season. I've been trying to stream my run, and for some reason, it's just not happening. It's just not happening. I keep running into the worst possible thing. On stream, I missed 3 rock slides in a row before my stream crashed, so I said, you know what? Let's just make a video at this point. But yeah, if you guys enjoy this at any point in time, do me a favor, leave a like, and then subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications, because I bring you daily Pokemon Sword and Shield content. And answer my comment question of the day: what do you think is the most underrated rock type in the format? As you can see, I just lost a match, and if you're wondering who I lost the match to, it was a ally switch Oranguru, which is fun. Always fun. Always a very fun thing to face, but that's whatever. Let's go ahead and just play some games. I'm trying to get out of Great Ball, which usually doesn't take this long. It usually doesn't. As you can see, I've only played 13 matches, and I actually took a while to actually just get into playing a couple of matches, because what is today? Today is like the 7th of June. I started like last week, later on in the week, not Monday, but pretty late in the week, and I just ended up not really playing since then. It looks like we're facing a team that's pretty much just Landorus, Stonjourner food. There isn't much they can do versus that, so I'm just going to go with it. In the back here, I'm going to go ahead and go with the Regieleki, because it feels really nice in this matchup, and I actually very much enjoy having Tapu Fini in the back here. But yeah, this is a Stonjourner team I built. I'll put a rental code in the description down below. Or actually, no, it's going to be in my Discord. So join the Discord if you're not part of it, but yeah. Let's see what we got. Yeah, I just want to get out of Great Ball so I can start actually laddering. Entei Zapdos. Not ideal, but a single speed boost feels really nice. I mean, they do have the option of trying to go for a burn on my Lando, which they might get. I will admit, there's a good chance they'll get it. But alternatively, I could do this. Do I Dynamax my... There's no chance Dynamaxing Stonjourner is the play here, right? Except it might be. I'm gonna do it. It should be a two-shot on Zapdos, and they should be going for an Airstream Sacred Fire. So, I mean, I can get Infinity here pretty much just to prevent that damage on the Lando more than anything, and also prevent a possible Sacred Fire burn on the Stonjourner. I don't think they're going to go for it, but for, you know, future reference, or for future use, it'll be nice. They should always Dynamax the Zapdos here, I think, as they just give it to me. Unless they're a slow Zapdos. I should just take this from them then. Which is interesting, because now I kind of wish I just double Rock Slided. They did not Dynamax. Maybe they went for like a Hurricane or a Heat Wave or something strange, but we just Dynamax the Stonjourner. We've committed. We have committed to this. Oh, my friend, I don't know if you want to do that. I don't know if that was ever your play. Maybe they're just expecting, like, Scarf Stonjourner or something? Because they Hurricane. Yeah, I don't know what that play was. I think I just one-shot this thing now. Get him out of here. Nice. Okay, cool. You know, it's been a while since I actually just sat down and recorded a laddering session. Typically, I just stream and upload the highlight, and that's because of how absurdly busy I am this summer. If you're wondering where the VGC iceberg is, I have been too busy to make it. I'm working 40 hours a week, I'm doing research, I have the YouTube channel itself, streaming. Everything's been very overwhelming, so there's a lot going on in my life that sort of prevents me from being able to complete that large project. So they get in Lapras the Tower Master. I should, emphasis on should, be able to just target down this Entei and give them my Lapras. And give them my Finny, I think. And the reason I want to do that is because on this next turn I'll be able to get in my Regieleki, and I should always take a hit from Lapras here. I should always take the hit. I'll Rockfall here. And then I'll be able to go for, like, Electroweb into Max Rockfall, and it'll do a decent chunk of damage to Lapras. Yeah, I was expecting them to Dynamax that, I was expecting them to Dynamax that Zapdos. It was pretty insane they didn't. They just extreme speed. That's going to knock me out, but I should be taking this Entei away from them, which is nice. Max Geyser, I should always survive that with Assault Vest plus my my sand on the field. Yeah, that does like nothing. That does like nothing. And I'm going to get my sand back up, so I almost think I win it. I think I win this exchange, to be honest. Let's go ahead and take this Entei from them. Their Entei privileges have been revoked. You can renew them at www.yourenteisgone.com. Alright. And now with... Honestly, I just feel good about this game. I'm going to go ahead and get my Eleki. I could also go Lando and try to Swords Dance, but it's not worth it. It's not worth it. There's the Drapion. There's the Drapion. Yeah, I always just prioritize the Lapras here, and I should be doing some pretty crazy damage if I actually go for this play. I'm gonna Screech, because I don't want to risk a weakness policy. Did we see a Life Orb? No, that's sand damage, right? Yeah, so I'm concerned about weakness policy. I wasn't paying attention, but if I Screech and get this Rockfall off, that should one-shot. I very much do not want to set off a weakness policy and lose my Stonjourner. As we miss a Screech, this guy has not landed a single Screech in his career, and that's very disappointing. On the bright side, though, they should always target my Stonjourner here, which means I'm going to keep my Eleki. And then I can just Volt Switch, and I should KO anyways. Because I have Power Spot. But yeah, that was a little bit annoying. Screech is 85% accuracy. It's about as accurate as a Will-O-Wisp, but it doesn't feel like it. I haven't landed a Screech in-game yet, and I've been playing this team for a while. That did like nothing, but the Volt Switch should do the trick. And at the very least, I just get in Landorus and start clicking Earthquake, and from this range, it'll do it. Yeah, there's the weakness policy, so Screech would have been the right play. But now that their Dynamax is over, I can just Volt Switch. Or actually, is there one more turn? I think there's one more turn. I could Electroweb and Rock Slide, and that might do it. I'm kind of tempted to do that. I'm kind of tempted to Electroweb Rock Slide because I think that'll KO. And then I'll outspeed. I'll go for it. I'll go for it. Just don't miss. Just don't miss, just don't miss, please. Like, honestly. I was going to say don't miss Lapras, but I'm talking to a Regieleki here. There's the Electroweb. Massive damage. That's Rock Slide range. That is Rock Slide range. And they should be targeting the Regieleki with their Drapion here, so I should be fine. They Night Slash me. Into the Eleki. I just have to connect a Rock Slide and I'm fine. And even if I don't, it's within range of Earthquake from Lando, so I'm good. Nice. Good game. Finally, some justice for Stonjourner. I went out and Mark hunted the Stonjourner only for it to, like, not do anything. Stonjourner the Apathetic. I wasn't even looking for it. I was just looking for any Mark, and I got lucky and got it in, like, my fifth catch. And now that they're at minus one from the Electroweb, I should be fine just to hit them with an Earthquake. Like, they're not outspeeding me unless they're Scarf. Hit them with the Earthquake. I'm going to knock out my own Stony too. So Stony's going to go out in a blaze of glory, getting KO'd by his own partner, Landorus. I'm going to upgrade some parts of my PC this summer. I am working quite a bit, and, you know, YouTube plus Twitch money has been pretty okay this month, so I think that plus my full-time job paycheck should allow me to upgrade some specs on my PC and maybe just build a new one outright. I think it's time to build a new one, honestly. Like, this guy has been... You ever hear of Theseus's ship or the ship of Theseus? My computer is the ship of Theseus. It has had every part completely changed. It's not the same computer, but I have never started a new computer, if that makes sense. It's the same computer I've always had, down to the fact that the hard drive is an HP hard drive from this pre-built computer I bought from Best Buy. It's that computer. It's the exact same computer. But the case has changed, the motherboard's changed, everything's different. Ship of Theseus, right there. Real world example. I really hope it's the ship of Theseus and I'm not misquoting it. That's the ship of Theseus, right? I'm not dumb. Oh, hey, this is the ally switch Marowak I lost to on stream. Not going to make that mistake again. Let's go ahead and lead off, right? I hate my life. I hate my life. Okay. Let me go Stony on lead. That was good last time. I forget what I led off with. I didn't lead off with Lando. I didn't lead off with Lando. I think I led off Metagross. So we're not going to make the same mistake twice. Hopefully they don't recognize me, so they just go for it again. I'm going to bring Regieleki, and I'm going to go ahead and bring the... I think Finny isn't a terrible idea, to be honest. We'll go with that. Lando also wouldn't be bad, but I think Finny might be safe. Yeah, we'll go Lando. We'll go Lando. Hopefully they don't recognize me. They should recognize me. I'm the only Stonjourner player on the ladder right now. But yeah, if they ally switch against me twice, I'm going to be upset. I'm going to be big sad. Maybe they just won't even lead off with the Marowak and I'll be able to KO it. Corviknight Pure Marina, that's fine. That's absolutely fine. I'm going to go ahead and prioritize that Primarina. I should be able to bulldoze here. And unless they're running like Tailwind, they shouldn't outspeed me. And a max Steel Spike should be fine. Because Corviknight's pretty slow. Stonjourner should be the fastest thing in the field right now. I have a good amount of speed on him and he's Jolly Nature, so this should be fine. Nothing safely switches in on Weakness Policy plus Life Orb Metagross. Like, nothing in, on Earth, on Poke Earth, on Mars, possibly Pluto. Nothing switches in. Alright, let's try this out. I don't think they're running Tailwind Corviknight. That'd be weird. Boink. Watch them be, like, faster than Metagross with the Primarina and have Parasong. Somehow. There's the Tailwind. They're gonna be running Tailwind Corviknight. I should be able to take one Liquid Voice hit on my Stony. They go for the Scald. I take that. Yeah, don't get burned, please. That'd be great. Awesome. Goodbye, Primarina. Nice knowing you. Now, something to be concerned about, and deeply so, deeply concerned about, is the fact that there is a Marowak that's going to come in and outspeed my Metagross, and I can go ahead and just double out into Lando, get minus one on it, and try to max Quake. But the issue here is the fact that the Marowak has access to Ally Switch. We know this because we faced it on stream not even like an hour ago. So if they come out with that, I don't like that. I'm just going to say I don't like it. Well, let's do our best not to lose. Please don't ally switch on me again. Get in my Lando for the Intimidate. I am just going to Quake. I'm not even going to call the ally switch because you wouldn't do it twice. You wouldn't do it twice, right? You're not going to do this to me, bud? You're not going to do it? Ally switch is a high skill move, I swear. Get a nice little Intimidate on them. And I suppose I can just cycle Intimidate. It's like, yeah, it's going to get reflected back onto my Lando, but I don't really mind too much. It's just going to come in and go out. Please just like Dynamax. I'd prefer the Dynamax because I should take one, I think. It's going to be close. It's going to be a real close hit. And if they like double into me with like Body Press or something, I'm not taking that. But if I can get rid of this Marowak, I'd be real happy, you know? It's the Iron Head, that's fine. That actually did a lot. Max Flare. Come on, Lando, you can...
Is that even the item? Is that the right item? Are they like a... No. There's no way you're not running Thick Club. That'd make no sense.
Because that is sad damage. Even at neutral, that's sad damage. Because you have 80 base attack. There's no way you're not running Thick Club. I'm going to have to look at this team. Because I didn't look at it last time. I just got sad and didn't fight them again. But here we are. Here we are.
All right. I'm pretty sure that's like the strongest possible steel spike that we did in that pre-marina. I mean, if we had like Steely Spirit in the field, but that's like the strongest possible one turn of setup steel spike, right? Like you'd have to have like Scarf Bulldoze. You'd have to have like Scarf Bulldoze Berserker, even if it even gets it, to deal more damage than that. So that's kind of insane. There's their Metagross. I'm just going to go ahead and say I win. I'm just going to say I think I win. I'm going to get in Stonjourner as an early celebration here, and I'm going to go ahead and just Quake them. Because this is stupid damage. They're likely just going to Iron Head and KO the Stonjourner, but it should still be funny. It should still be a funny little meme. As the Earthquake. Interesting. So I just want to point out that Metagross was never going to die to that. Iron Head, yeah, no, they're kind of just flailing at this point. Just doing their best. Cool. So we got a revenge on that player. Critical hit didn't even matter. I'm going to go ahead and get in the Eleki and end this. All right, Reginald, get in there. Volt Switch, make your dad proud. All right. I'm gonna go ahead and Volt Switch on this guy. And we'll Ice Punch, not that it matters. I could like click any move and after a Volt Switch it'd KO. If the Volt Switch doesn't just outright do it. Which it does. Thank you, Reginald Eleki. You're kind of broken. And there was a crit. That explains it. I was going to say, I'm pretty sure that doesn't one-shot if they're like special defensive, which a lot of Corviknight tend to be. Just because you already have such good physical bulk and Steel Spike such a good physical defense booster that you can afford to be more specially defensive just to compensate. Let's get one more battle. And also, I'm going to view their team. I want to look at... Oh, I didn't. I should have looked at their team. I should have looked at their team. I'm really curious on that... On that Marowak spread. And there we are, Ultra Ball tier. Out of Great Ball Hell. We're good. Din, 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 din. I did it. Off stream. On video, though. So that's cool. Alright. Let's see what we got. Nick, rank 10. Just Colossal Azumarill, but it's probably Parish Song non-threatening Azumarill. I mean, like, that's the best way to say it. Parish Song non-threatening Azumarill, because I can just lead off Rillaboom here. And if they're Parish Song, that means that they're likely Sap Sipper, so I have to be careful with that. I actually really like the Rillaboom Lando lead. I'll bring Stony in the back. And I think for my last Mon, I just go Finny every time. Eleki wouldn't be bad, but it's also not as reliable as Finny is in this matchup, especially versus Colossal. Like, Colossal is pretty scary for unprepared teams, but I think we have the tools to beat it. This is a cool team, though. I wouldn't mind losing to this, because it's Colossal with a Parasong option, a little bit of anti-Trick Room with a Glacier on there, so that's a cool-looking team. And trust me, I know a cool-looking team. I'm the Stonjourner guy right now. I'm also the Thievul guy, the Golisopod guy, the didn't-make-it-into Players' Cup 4 because I decided to run Absol and Qualifiers guy. You know, I'm that guy, you know? All right, let's see what we got. So they go Incineroar or Gothitelle. I actually have some pretty great offensive potential here. I'm somewhat tempted to Swords Dance on like a parting shot. Because if I were them, I would expect Lando to Dynamax or U-turn or something. So I think they're going to parting shot, if anything. And fake out on Goth is looking real good here. And then I can taunt it, which is going to be great. So I'll Swords Dance here. A little bit risky, but the Swords Dance play does seem pretty good. And if they end up, like, Flare Blitzing into my into my Rillaboom for some reason, I get a free switch into my Stonjourner, and then nothing takes Airstream, not even Incineroar. So let's see if they opt to fake out the Lando or just Parting Shot. Even if they just decide to Parting Shot it, I still end up... Did they just Protect? I'm sorry, that's just the only reaction I have. Did they just Protect? I'm going to go ahead and taunt this Gothitelle. They don't typically run Mental Herb, but I should be fine just to Quake this Incineroar, or even Airstream at this point. Plus one Life Orb Airstream. Adamant Nature. Like, I feel good. So we'll taunt here. Actually, you know what? You know what? I'm going to do it. You're going to Parting Shot me. Or just switch out. Check it. Check it. I'm going to Swords Dance again. I'm going to do it. They're switching out this Incineroar. They're not staying in. There's no way. There's no way. And if they're not Mental Herb, I think I just win on this turn. If they're not Mental Herb, I think I just win. Which there's a good chance they are, which is kind of scary. I have to admit, that's kind of scary. But I also still haven't Dynamaxed, so I could, like, Dynamax Rillaboom or something. You know? It's all good. It's all good. Did you just do what I think you just did? Sir. 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 No, don't do this. First of all, I live, but also, sir, why? Please don't be Mental Herb. I'd really love it if you weren't. Sir. Sir, no. Sir. I think I take this just because it's Lando. But also, sir. Do you need an adult? I think they need an adult. This feels like a panic play if I've ever seen one. Max Flare. Incineroar? Don't. Oh, wow, that was sad. That was comically low damage. I gotta say, that was what we in the industry call comically low damage. I'm gonna go ahead and annihilate your Incineroar now with a Max Quake. And I kinda have to stay in, so I might as well just Grassy Glide for damage. Like, I don't want a Wood Hammer, it's not worth it. What am I saying? It's totally worth it. Give me that. No, not another Swords Dance. imagine the look on their face if we just Swords Danced again. Watch them get in like a Zoom roll and just have it get annihilated. But yeah, that's what we in the industry refer to as comically low damage. As they just said, okay, yeah, Incineroar, that was a cool Dynamax, but you're out. Nothing switches in on this. Yeah, no, you're taking, like, this is plus three. You're taking, like, 50%. Minimum 50%. And Glacier's not going to appreciate a Wood Hammer either. This is going to be comically high damage. I'm pretty confident, like, this is just too much for you. Prepare yourself for comically high damage. I almost Airstreamed. I'm gonna keep it real with you. I almost Airstreamed, but it didn't feel worth it. Because I wouldn't have KO'd Incineroar. That was hilarious. That was hilarious. I can't stress how funny that was. I can't stress how funny that was. I am laughing so hard on the inside right now. Can I crit this just for a double? Nah, still funny though. Still funny. Ooh, you wanna see something really funny? You wanna see something really funny? I think if I switch in my, I think if they try to protect this thing, and I switch in my Stonjourner, I might just still KO it. That'd be, now that'd be hilarious. Just because I'm at plus three. But of course, if they get in Gothitelle, then I can't. But Stonjourner would win anyways, so I'm just gonna KO Gothitelle regardless. Here comes Incineroar. There he goes. Here he comes. He's on his way to fake out my Rillaboom. In comes the Stonjourner. So I can KO this Glastrier with an Airstream. No Quake required. It's like a church hymn. Yeah, no, this Glastrier's gone. Comically high damage. Stonjourner the apathetic does not care for your pitiful needs. You know, you're probably thinking, I can live this. Stonjourner the apathetic does not care. He is apathetic. How much is this doing? Oh my god. If they didn't intimidate me, that would have actually KO'd. Once again, I must say it, comically high damage. We in the industry call that comically high damage. Go ahead and Flare Blitz. I'm going to take like 30 at most. And I mean 30 HP. And yeah, that was 80 HP, but that was a crit, so. So it doesn't get, and they burn me. Okay, well, it's still comically high damage. I believe they're in range of a Rock Slide, but I don't want to risk it anymore because I'm scared. I mean, I could always just Rock Slide with Landorus and Rock Slide with Stonjourner, and it should still be fine. So, this is a plus two Rock Slide with life. Oh, wait, I don't need a Rock Slide. Yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and do this. My priority is going to be this. Yeah, I mean, just do that. Incineroar is gone. Gothitelle is gone, unless they switch it in here, which they do. But Incineroar is just gone. It's over. It's funny. Comically high damage right here. That is very funny. Oh, they lived. Okay. Yeah, Incineroar kind of gross. But it's not taking this Rock Slide in a turn. And they kind of have to choose here if they want a Trick Room or live. Can I not miss the Goth? That'd be great. Alright. Is Grassy Terrain gone? Because if it is, I'm just going to Earthquake. Like, I don't even care about Stonjourner, I'm just going to Earthquake. Yeah, Grassy Terrain's gone, it's time to Earthquake. They can fake out me, they can do whatever, but they're not getting this Trick Room off. Let me see this. Let me see this. Let me look at this, this stat. Yeah, I'm at plus two, I have a Life Orb, and I have a Stonjourner next to me. We're just Earthquaking. We're actually just going to Earthquake and see if that KOs, because regardless, Rillaboom will come in and clean up. I kind of really hope this actually just KOs the Gothitelle. Like, I'm going to get a triple KO, right? But it'll be funny. As Incineroar protects, and it fails, and I Earthquake, and they have a Shookaberry. That is funny. Comically high damage. That's the fun part about Stonjourner. Just the damage output you gain is insane. I really want to run Stonjourner next to, like, Dracozolt. I want to try that out, like Hustle Dracozolt, or Hustle Durant. That'd be even funnier. That'd be the funniest version of this. Alright. I think this game's over. I'm gonna see how much I do this Tapu Fini. I'm really curious how much I do to Tapu Fini as they just forfeit. Nice. That's a very satisfying way to end off this video. And, you know, I'm almost in Master Belt here, so my struggle ended as soon as I cut loose and started using Stonjourner the way he was intended to be used, so that's cool. I want to take a look. How far am I? Ranked battles. By the way, my girlfriend participated in Hatterene series this weekend, and it was her first ever tournament. She got 30th out of 137th, and I'm really proud of her. So, yeah, that was really cool. She's getting into competitive mons now, and I'm really excited about that, because it's just another thing we can do together. Nice. Stonjourner kind of gross. I'm going to keep battling with this team in a few more videos and streams and stuff, just because it's a fun little team. So, yeah. If you guys enjoyed, leave a like, subscribe to the channel, turn on notifications, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.